divided this chapter into two parts. And the very first part I will be discussing in your class, and HO3 sir will take the second part. Since we are going to discuss current electricity, so let's first interpret the name. So actually we see that there are two terms, one is current and the other is electricity. So what does the word signifies? Current, it doesn't mean electric current. Current means it is flow, and this current or this flow may be of anything like water current, electric current or some other. And this electricity, actually this word is derived from electron, or in other words it also means charge. So here if you combine these words, we see that flow of electron or flow of charge. That means in this part we will be discussing only those topics where the charge is not at rest, while the charge is in motion, it is not static, rather it is dynamic. So in this chapter we will mainly discussing the charge when it is in motion. So let us consider one uncharged metallic conductor. Whatever be the material, like it may be copper, aluminium, silver. Now in such type of conductors, we often see that there are large number of free electrons which keeps moving in all possible directions. So what is the source? What is the actual source of these free electrons? Where they come from? Actually, the this conductor, it is not connected to any source, so it is electrically neutral. Still, there are existence of free electrons. And it is neutral, that means the number of positive charges and negative charges in this conductor is balanced. Then, how these electrons get dissociated from these atoms of this particular material? Actually, it is the thermal excitation or thermal internal energy, which where sun is the main source. At room temperature, because of this temperature, even in this temperature, some electrons from the outermost shells of different atoms get dissociated from the atoms. And these free electrons keeps moving in all possible directions across this conductor. And these are the mainly free electrons, and which is also known as electron clouds. Electron clouds. Free electrons or electron clouds means these are electrons which get dissociated from atoms in a conductor due to thermal excitation. And these electrons keeps moving in all possible directions. So these are free electrons. Now in this case we see that electrons are the charge carriers. So we find there are different charge carriers also. So we consider different states of matter. First we consider that a solid conductor actually. So in case of solid, who are the mainly charge carriers? It is very clear, electrons are the only source, or electrons are the only charge carriers in case of metals or other solids. So we can write like this, this is electron. In case of liquid, in school all of you studied about electrolysis, like this. Suppose there is an electrolyte solution like NaCl. If you immerse two electrodes and one is connected to positive terminal, the other one is negative, then we see that splitting of this NaCl takes place, and these ions get so separated like Na plus, Cl minus. So in this liquid medium, we say that this positive ion, this negative ion are the mainly charge carriers which keeps moving from one terminal to different terminals. So here we see that positive, negative ions are the main charge carriers. Now, insulator. In case of insulators, actually there is no such type of charge gradient. That's why it is insulator. Otherwise, if there were some certain free electrons, then it would also have conduct. In case of insulators, there is no such charge carrier. इसीलिए तो ये conduct नहीं करता है. अगर यहाँ पे free electrons होता तो ये भी conductivity बन गया होता. Next, gas. In case of gases, there is no such charge carrier, but there are special cases like plasma or ionized gases. So, in case of plasma and ionized gases, we see that electrons and positive ions are the mainly charge carriers. So, here it is, electron, ions, etc. These are the mainly charge. Now, what is electric current? Consider a conductor, and through this conductor, what is the rate of flow of electron? The rate at which electron flows is known as electric current. So, definition of electric current, it is the rate of flow of charge. Or in other words, we can say it is the amount of charge passing through a conductor in 1 second. It is the amount of charge passing through a conductor in 1 second, irrespective of the area of cross section of this conductor. Whatever be the area of cross section, just we have to consider this area of this conductor, and what is the amount of charge that crosses in 1 second. This is actually the magnitude of current to a conductor. So here we can write irrespective of area of cross section. So this is the definition of electric current. So mathematically we can write current I equals to charge by time. And if you denote charge by capital Q and time by T, so the expression becomes I equals to Q by T. This is one expression for electric current. Now the same thing can be expressed in terms of number of electrons. If you consider that n is the number of electrons passing through this portion of this conductor, then if n is the number of electrons, then we can write Q equals to n. In that case, I becomes I equals to Ne divided by T. So this is the new expression for electric current in terms of number of electrons. Now there is another question there, whether this electric current is a scalar or vector. Actually we see that there are directions of electric current. Whenever we draw an electric circuit, just we consider the simplest circuit like this. This is one bulb which is connected to a source of battery like this. Now, in this case, we see the direction of current is in clockwise direction. That is like this. Current is flowing through this circuit like this. If you recall this formula of resultant in case of vector addition, we see that this is equals to R square plus B square plus twice AB cos theta. Now what is this theta? Theta actually represents the angle between these two vectors. So that's why there is a vector which varies batteries. But in case of current electricity, we see that to consider like suppose there is a current passing through this conductor like 5 ampere, then another current moving in this direction, to consider this is as 3 ampere. Here we will be getting a resultant of 8 ampere. Now if you change the angle between these two incident current, let's change the direction of this orientation of this conductor, let it be like this. So in this case, ऐसा हो सकता है कि ये करंट का मैग्नीट्यूड डिफरेंट कुछ हो जाएगा? नहीं, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है. ये एंगल कुछ भी रहे पर यहाँ पे जो रिजल्टेंट है वो हमेशा सेम ही रहेगा. तो यहाँ पे एंगल कुछ मैटर नहीं करता है. जैसे कि अगर ये दोनों वेक्टर हो गया होता तो यहाँ पे रिजल्टेंट जो आता तो वो भी डिफरेंट हो गया. तो इसीलिए यहाँ पे ऐसा हो रहा है कि इलेक्ट्रिक करंट में हम लोगों को डायरेक्शन दिखाई दे रहा है, फिर भी अगर मैंने दो करंट वायर्स कनेक्टेड कंसीडर कर लिया तो इन दोनों के बीच में जो भी एंगल रहेगा आउटपुट में कुछ भी चेंज नहीं रहेगा, वो सेम ही रहेगा इन बोथ केसेस. दैट्स व्हाई दो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट हैज डायरेक्शंस बट इट डज नॉट फॉलो वेक्टर रिलेशंस. मतलब इसका कोई यूज नहीं है. यहां पे नॉर्मल एल्जेब्रिक सम इज सफिशिएंट है किसी भी कंडक्टर में या किसी भी वायर में करंट का हिसाब लगाने के लिए. तो हम लोग ये बोल सकते हैं कि इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज ए स्केलर क्वांटिटी दो इट हैज डायरेक्शंस इट इज स्केलर बिकॉज इट डज नॉट फॉलो वेक्टर एडिशन रूल्स. मोरओवर इन हायर क्लासेस यू विल स्टडी अबाउट द टेंसर्स. यू नो दैट स्केलर क्वांटिटीज आर आल्सो टेंसर्स विद रैंक 0. So it can also be said that electric current is a tensor. But in our HS classes, अगर हम लोगों ने ये scalar और vector के बीच में limited कर दिया तो भी ठीक है, कोई problem नहीं. अगर चाहो तो तुम लोग बोल सकते हो कि it's a tensor quantity, otherwise scalar only is sufficient.